What is up, guys? Jimmy or Chaos, welcome to the first video on the channel of 2018. And I know YouTubers usually do these videos saying what they're going to do in 2018, a look back at 2017, and this is kind of going to be like that. I don't know. I had a Discord member over on my Discord server say yesterday that he loves the content, but he misses the more personal commentaries from time to time. And I thought this was a perfect time to kind of give you guys a special message. Talk about what happened in 2017 and what my expectations are for myself and for this channel and for you guys in 2018. And I'll tell you now, it's going to be hard for this year to top last year when it comes to just jaw-dropping moments. I mean, it was a crazy year across the board. I'm sure everybody can attest to that. And I want you guys to, in the comment section, let me know, what was the craziest thing that happened in 2017 in your eyes? It doesn't have to be at you personally. It could have just been across the board. I want to know. Now, let's talk about 2017 as a whole for me, for the channel, for the content, everything like that. It was a special year for me. The channel, it did very well. We're almost to 2 million subscribers. We did a lot of growth in the 2017 year gap when it came to the channel, and I kind of got some consistency, if you will. A lot of you know, at the beginning of last year, it's crazy that I say it's last year now, that I kind of moved away from Call of Duty at that time and focused more on the top 10s, the video games, and did things like that. And it really, really worked out. There's a lot of people that enjoy that content. I added the Fact series, and that's kind of where we're going right now. I don't post a lot of Call of Duty, and I know there are a lot of Call of Duty fans that want that and tell me all the time, but most people are cool. If I'm enjoying myself and in the content I'm making, they're happy with it, which is awesome. You guys absolutely rock. I still do the Sunday Call of Duty COD History Top 10s. Those aren't going anywhere, and I'm not making any promises that I won't jump back in when we get the next Call of Duty. I've got other things that have my focus right now. And the top 10s, the Fact series, and Fortnite. Fortnite has me engrossed, and I love the game. I don't get a lot of views on it, but I love playing it even if it's not for a video, and that's different for me. I haven't really got into grinding games in a while, and the fact that I can do that with Fortnite, it's pretty invigorating to me. So that's where I'm at right now. What is going to happen in 2018? I don't know. A lot of people think that we are going to get Black Ops 4 from Treyarch. Obviously, that is going to be very interesting to see how that plays out. I want to know, are you playing COD World War II? Are you grinding it? People tweet at me and say, do you hate the game? You're not posting it. I don't hate the game at all. I actually enjoy the game more than I have Call of Duty in a while. My focus is elsewhere right now, and I've kind of bridged that gap of being able to do content other than Call of Duty. But I don't hate the game at all. I enjoy the game. I really enjoy the game. I just have other focuses right now. But who knows? Treyarch's going to be popping out a title. Whenever Treyarch pops out a Call of Duty title, you have to pay attention. I mean, your head has to turn, and you kind of have to give it, you have to give it some attention to see what's going on, because they obviously, they know what they're doing, and they put out some really, really crazy stuff. That'd be Black Ops 3. People are still grinding this game religiously 3 years later. So we'll see what happens with that. Going back to 2017, I felt like it was a year that I got in touch with you guys more. Maybe toward the end of the year. I launched the Discord server. It's over 2,000 members. I'm in there every single day with the mods, the admins, everybody that's in there. When somebody joins the server, everybody welcomes them. We have a prestige system set up where people, the more active they are, they can move up. We've got custom chaos emotes and all kinds of stuff. It's fun. I tried it in the past and I dropped the ball, and I didn't really nurture it, if you will. And now it is full-blown a place where I can go and interact. I do open voice calls with people in there. It's just, I wanted to make it a point toward the end of last year and all the way into this year to really get in touch with you guys the best I can. You can't do that in a YouTube video comment section. Now, I do it on Twitter, super active on Twitter, but this is another layer of that when it comes to the Discord server. So if you guys want to interact with me, I'll put a link in the description to that. Some goals for me. And I know everybody does this, and people say, why don't you have those goals right now instead of saying what you're going to do in 2018? Well, it's just kind of a thing. We do it, so I'm going to do it. But these are all goals that I'm working on actively now. And I put these on Twitter the other day. Goal number one, to get closer to my viewer base. And like I said, I talked about that with Twitter, with Discord, and I want to continue on that path in 2018. Goal number two, to continue to balance my family and my work time. I've gotten way, way better in 2017, 2016, 2015. YouTube kind of engrossed me and I didn't really know how to balance it. And it was tough at a time. And I know some people say, YouTube's not a job, whatever. Whether you label it or deem it a job or not, it takes up a lot of my time. So I had to figure out how to balance that because I have a big family and I don't want to be stuck in front of a monitor and miss life as my kids grow up or spending time with my wife, so on and so forth. So I did really good at that. I did way, way better in 2017 and I want to build off of that in 2018. The next thing is, I want to become a crypto millionaire. And I'm dead serious with this. If you follow me on Twitter, over on Discord, you know that I've been into cryptocurrency investing for about a year now. And it's a passion. It has turned into a labor of love and a passion. And I'm pretty good at it. I'm not trying to brag or become an advice crypto advisor or anything like that. But I've done pretty well at it. And I have high expectations as I learn it, which you have to learn anything you're trying to excel at. You have to dive in, do your research, and learn. But I know a lot of you are hearing crypto and Bitcoin and Ethereum and Ripple, and you're wondering what it is. Well, to me, it's the digital age, which is just launching. And a lot of people compare it to the dot-com bubble. And if you don't know what that was, back when dot-coms, as in dot-com websites, were the big thing, there were tons of billionaires and millionaires made when it was going. And then, of course, it kind of died down, which everything does. And if we were to compare cryptocurrency to that, the new digital age, as far as I'm concerned, I think we're at the very, 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 very beginning of what would have been like the dot-com bubble. Will it go for a long time? Who knows? Will it bust? Who knows? But I feel like we're on the forefront still because it hasn't even been adopted into mainstream hardly at all. And I'm excited about that. So my goal is to build my portfolio, my cryptocurrency portfolio, to over $1 million in 2018. My next goal is personal. It's health and fitness. A lot of you have followed me for a long, long time. You know I used to be 300 pounds, which was 3 or 4 years ago now. And I got down to around 250. And I've literally bounced around there. I lost about 50 pounds. And I've bounced around there pretty much for the last 2 or 3 years. So it is time to get that last 25 to 30 pounds. I want to be around 220 is where I want to be for my weight and my build and my height. I'm 6'2". And that is a focus of mine. That is a goal of mine that I want to get done. Not in 2018. I want to get it done in the first quarter or first half of 2018. Not just because I want to lose the weight and feel good, because I want to prolong my life. I want to be healthy. I want to be able to do stuff and travel and spend time with the kids and the wife and all that good stuff. And all that is predicated on being healthy, being able to actually do stuff. So that is a focus of mine. And other than that, just seeing where the year goes, kind of sitting back and watching. I've gotten better at not diving into drama and crap on Twitter and things like that. I'm just kind of past that, the YouTube drama, all that stuff. There was a time where I was totally engrossed in it, enthralled in it, giving my opinion, and I figured out that it's not really worth the energy to me. I guess if I want to give my opinion on something, I can, but there are other positive things for me in life that I would rather focus on than worrying about all that. Now, I'm not going to lie. I'm going to go troll and look at the drama too, just like anybody else. I'm a rubbernecker. I'll watch from a distance, but I'm not like dead center, right in the middle of it, front and center, if you will, when it comes to drama. And that's pretty much in a nutshell what 2018 is going to look like for me. Right now with the channel, it's pretty consistent. Every day I do a Fortnite video or a commentary, maybe a COD commentary, something in there during the day at like 2 or 3 o'clock. And then 8 o'clock on the dot, on the nose every night, is a video game top 10, which is my biggest series. right now. And then at 11 o'clock for my late night squad people, I throw a facts video out there. It's basically in-depth facts. It could be about anything. We've done Donald Trump. We've done Elon Musk. We've done Rockstar Games. We've done the end of the world. We've done all kinds of stuff. Literally just going and trying to find cool facts that maybe you didn't know. The whole point of the series is for you to walk away from the series saying, wow, Jimmy just told me something that I didn't know, and that's pretty cool. So that's the point and the goal of that series, and that's it. I did make a promise about 6 months ago, if I hit 2 million subscribers, I was gonna give away a car, and I'm gonna hold to that. Now, people are like, are you gonna give away a Tesla supercar? No, no, it's gonna be a car. It's not gonna be a beater car. But I don't know if any other YouTuber has done that yet. I know Keemstar's donated a car to somebody or money, but I don't know. Anyway, I'm going to figure it out. But if we hit 2 million subscribers this year, somebody's getting a car. And I don't know the logistics of how I'm going to do that yet, but I'm going to hold true to my word. So that should be interesting as well. And that's it, guys. Special message to you is simple. Thank you. Thank you from the bottom of my heart. Thank you for supporting me. Without you guys, the channel's nothing. I know content creators create the content, but if there's nobody there to view the content, it's like the whole adage, if a tree falls in the woods and nobody's around, can you hear it? Well, nobody would hear me. And because of you guys, people hear me. And I'm truly, truly grateful and humble and always will be. So thank you. If you made it all the way to the video, I hope you have an amazing 2018. And I'll see you guys tonight for a video game top 10.